All right, folks, welcome back. Chris Garlock here once again with Michael Redmond for our latest edition of AlphaGo versus the world as we work our way through all 60, that's right, count them, all 60 of the Magister slash Master games played back in late 2016, early 2017. All right, Michael, who is our, I know this player. What can you tell us about this player?
KJ?
Can you pronounce him right? Because I sure can't.
I think he's actually, he's not the number one player in world ranking anymore. But, you know, for a long time he was. And world ranking is a bit informal anyway. Like, there's various places where they do it. But he is one of the most formidable players in the world. And probably the top player at the time. He's been world champion 7 times. So he's very, and he's one of the more interesting players. Like, he, I think he tweets and he does all sorts of stuff. He's a bit more colorful than most of the young
players. Colorful go. We're talking about that before. Talking about how in all the young, mostly the young tennis players have all the color drained right out of them, and it can be the same for the Go players, although I think for different reasons. But and you were pointing out, I think, you know, a good point that a lot of these younger folks, they're just more used to the social media and aware that it can get them in trouble.
Yeah, but, well, KJ can be a bit more sharp and exciting in the after game discussion. Yeah. And so, yeah, he could potentially get into trouble, I think. But he sort of gets away with it. He's quite a personality.
Cool. But does he get in trouble?
Skill player. So KJ, he has the white stones in this game.
Uh-huh.
And you might have noticed that AlphaGo was playing a large knight Shimari a lot, and that was usually when white had played a 3-4 point here, and then AlphaGo would play the large knight Shimari, and I really like this move, and people are already noticing that. I think KJ might be the first player to try the star point and see what AlphaGo does with that. So AlphaGo now shows the two-space high Shimari, which was very new at the time, but it became the normal move after that. Like, this is still a very popular move. And after this version of AlphaGo, there were a lot of professionals trying it out. Like, before AlphaGo, it was like there were maybe 2 players in Japan who liked to play this. One of them was Omeyan, by the way. He's one of my favorite players.
Mm-hmm.
And Omeyan, he said himself that he played it and he messed it up every time or something like that. He couldn't continue with it. And so he said he was learning a lot from watching AlphaGo use this move.
Cool.
Of course, he was very modest about it because he did win a lot of those games where he played that Shimari. But he said that he was messing it up every time. So white plays this. This is a good point for black to be playing. Like, I think that computer programs and most modern games, you can see white playing a 3-3 invasion at this point. You've probably seen it in a lot of professional games. But also for black, after finishing the upper right corner there, at some point playing this Kakari is also going to be a big move. So playing here for white, it makes sense. It's a reasonable point. It reduces black's potential. In fact, I think you can probably see this move in some of the AlphaGo self-played games, AlphaGo versus AlphaGo games even. So it's a move that AlphaGo might choose also. Black plays a shoulder hit, right? Obviously.
Of course.
And now AlphaGo plays away. So this is a case where AlphaGo is not playing that jump. This jump here on the fourth line seemed to be one of the moves that Master likes to play. But in this case, it's just playing away. So a more fast-paced move. And one of the problems that people were having with AlphaGo in this series of games is the fact that it was sort of hard to predict exactly what AlphaGo would do. Like, it did have some patterns that lasted for the first 3 moves with a star point and some kind of a corner enclosure. And then it would be playing moves that they had not expected. So it wasn't as if it was playing the same game every time. And that made it a lot more interesting for me to do commentaries on the games.
Sure.
But I think it made it, it was not like a computer program that we expected at the time, and that it had a lot of variety of styles that it could play. So it's very straightforward so far. And white jumps into the corner. This is okay. Black jumps now. White plays here. There's no problem. It's 50-50 so far, except for the fact that a 6.5 pomi is supposed to be slightly better for black, maybe. It's a very subtle difference. But when white plays here, this move is expanding the right side at the same time as reducing black's potential in the center. And this is actually the type of move that AIs do not like. And so the moment white plays here, white's score is going to go down down to something like 45% winning percentage.
Oh, wow.
Lila or Kadago would be suggesting just an opening point. And this is just the way computer programs play, because they're so good at diving into that moyo when black plays, for instance, something like this. Most human players would have trouble reducing this moyo that black has in an effective manner. Like, we could jump in and live. Even I could jump in and live inside the black moyo. But by the time I'm alive, I could be losing the game anyway. And it's very difficult to find the best way to reduce that moyo. And the computers just leave it for a while. And you might remember that from my commentaries on AlphaGo Zero, because it's really annoying the way that it just sort of ignores the moyo until you think it's territory, and then it jumps in.
That's right.
So this move, it reduces white's winning percentage, and black plays a big move on the lower side. This is sort of different, but it's putting pressure on white in the lower left corner. And I think I did a commentary on this game too. This might be one of the games that I did a commentary on. And I was very surprised by KJ's next move, because KJ did not defend the corner. And instead, he jumped in here and allowed black to slide into the corner. And I didn't understand that. And so I was thinking it was just something that KJ was doing that I was not capable of understanding, because he was a player who did things differently and very sure. successfully against other humans, of course. But it turns out that in this case, Leela agreed with me and continued with the corner just like this. A very orthodox, normal way of playing for white, just to secure the corner territory, allow black to play this move. The problem is that it's so obvious that this is black's, you might say, plan to play that one kakari, the marked stone. I'll mark this black stone. So playing that with sente and then playing this extension on the side, is just, it's so obvious that this is what black was planning to do, and white was just trying to mess with that plan, basically.
Right.
But it turns out that the normal way that I would have played, any professional player would think of something like this to start with. This would be our first idea. So it's not as if I was finding anything special. It was just the normal move. And then white could continue with an invasion to the upper side. And this would be perfectly okay for white.
Sure.
Apart from the fact that the score has gone down just a little bit, 5% difference is not something that I would notice in a game. Actually, I would still think the game was even. So white invades here, and black gets the slide. Just the fact that black is putting pressure on that white group, and the fact that black has this fairly strong position now on the side, the base of black's group and the loss of part of white's base is just important. So white peeps here and crawling here. At this point, Katago is already giving black a 60% winning percentage. Mm. So that's something. 60% is, in this case, it seems to be a couple of points at least.
Mm-hmm.
So it's getting close to 10 points on the board.
Wow.
But actually, the move that I really want to point out is coming up, because this is another game where AlphaGo is going to show off beautiful shape in the center of the board. Because we come to a point where now the left side, white's alive on the side there. Obviously, all of black's groups are safe also, because black has a base in the corner. So this black group is 100% alive. And so now the focus goes to white's moyo, white's area in the lower right, and how black is supposed to reduce this.
Yeah, I was just looking at Ton. I mean, it's really large, and it looks like, you know, on the line there between the O13 and the L7, you know, there should be either a room for a, yeah.
And like when what people tell you when you're when they're trying to give you a lesson is that you look for a point somewhere along that line so that you can get in.
Yeah.
You don't
yeah.
get surrounded from outside. Nope. Black just dived in all the way. This was an extremely effective move. I remember at the time, if I remember correctly, I was saying that white should have played a capping move here.
Yeah.
In this case, black will probably play something like this. Although black is going to sacrifice the lower side, black should be able to live on the right side fairly easy. So this is black. You could say this is black's plan. But this might have been better than the game. In the game, white actually crawled here. And I really love black's next move because black played this large, nice move.
Right.
And because black has that exchange there, because of this black stone here, for instance, this is the fight got heated up at this point, but it's already very bad for white. Actually, black's winning by much more than 10 points at this point. So it's more than 60%, more like 64-65%. But still, like, it's a difficult, such a tactically difficult position that in a human-human game, black would still have potential to lose the game. In fact, I wouldn't even know who's winning. But the fact that black has this stone here and the potential to play moves like this or moves like this to develop towards the right side of the board, it gives that much more potential to black. And it turns out that black has and the way AlphaGo finished this off was worth watching too. But already at this point, the game, AlphaGo is saying the game is over at this point.
Oh, please. It's such an elegant reduction too. It's just, it's almost like black is just dancing around in there. And you know, of course that moyo wasn't finished mm-hmm. by any means, but you know, very difficult. And I never would have come up with that. I mean, I would have thought it was, I thought about the shoulder hit earlier, actually, you know, when there was a lot fewer moves on the board.
It's like black is almost threatening to attack white. So it's hard to see who's attacking here. And that's what makes it so effective. There's an aggressive part side to this move.
Cool. Nice analysis, nice game, fun to see. And I have to go back and look at the commentary that we did. It must be fun
for
you.
I really like this move the first time too. Like I really like this move.
Cool. All right, folks. Hope you're enjoying them as much as we are, and stick with us. We'll be back with more. But thanks for watching this one, and we will see you next time.